Let's talk about one of the most influential and underrated anime directors in history. The man who has contributed to such great works like Evangelion in his multiple movies, more underground shows like Dive Buster, and my personal favorite anime of all time, Fooly Cooly. Let's talk about Kazuya Tsurumaki. On February 2nd, 1966, the one who would give a voice to all losers out there was born. He grew up in a place called Ghost in Japan and spent most of his early 20s doing key animation for different studios. This was until he was capable of landing a job at a very famed animation studio in Japan called Dynax. Getting this job would shape the rest of his career and give way for his directorial debut. He quickly rose the ranks of studio Dynax and was subsequently scouted and hired as an assistant director by a man named Hideaki Anno. Known for his insane, brutal, weird series, Neon Genesis Evangelion. He worked alongside Hideaki Anno on Evangelion, eventually making his way to become co-director of the series finale, End of Evangelion. After all his hard work, Tsurumaki's mentor Hideaki Anno decided that he was up next, and it became time for his directorial debut, full solo. I find it interesting that he worked on Evangelion first, because his directorial debut was in the same sort of vein as Evangelion. Absurdist, kind of comedic, kind of strange, kind of wild, coming-of-age story, centered around portraying stories that are incredibly personal to each director respectively. Though the road was tough towards his directorial debut, he had a lot of issues planning out the series and figuring out, like, just what sort of story he wanted to tell. But during a recent interview in 2016, he stated that, "Anno told me that you don't have to make something perfect that everyone will love. Just do what you want to create." He worked on Evangelion, which is widely received to be depressing and somber. Tsurumaki wanted to create something wacky and outrageous while still utilizing his youthful voice, and thus, Fooly Cooly was born.
Nothing really special ever happens here. In this place. School sucks. My dad's a weirdo. And there's my brother's girlfriend. I don't even know what to say about her. Anyway, life was pretty slow. Until she came along. Next thing I knew, I had things coming out of my head.
Fooly Cooly follows the story of a boy named Naruto Nandabe, and his life is turned upside down by the introduction of a strange woman named Haruko, who rides onto the scene on Yellow Vespa and hits him in the head with her guitar. Yeah, he really went for it and managed to tell a decisive story in about just 6 episodes. Tsurumaki mentions he was lucky enough to be working with a studio like Dynax. They essentially let him do whatever he wanted with the series, which led to the inclusion of all of his crazy interests. For example, he was obsessed with yellow Vespas, cool guitars, and giant robots. It was a weird mix, but it was him. In this video, I want to focus on his work in Fooly Cooly and how it affected me personally, particularly the freedom that Tsurumaki has for his voice. Given the circumstance, he really pushed his limits on the series. And when I say pushing his limits, I mean using things like mixed media in his anime.
It's you, the Vespa woman!
Why are you yelling?
Hurry up and sit down!
Hi.
Which for the time was very strange and kind of like not something that was normally done. And I find that really interesting that he just was like, this is something that I like, I'm gonna like put it in there. Along with this, he decided to implement music, which he enjoyed, which was one of my favorite parts of the series as a whole. Tsurumaki decided that the J-Rock band The Pillows would be a perfect backdrop for the series. They have a grungy sound that aligns perfectly with the show's themes. I believe Fooly Cooly is special because of this freedom they have, and how it is simply a reflection of the director's interest in things he loves. It's a gem because of how personal it is and how people can relate to the stories with it. The series hit me at a perfect time in my life, a time when I was going through much of the same things that the main character was, so it always stuck with me. And personally, I always wish I could make something as strange and creative as it. Something that encapsulates who I am as a person, just as much as Fooly Cooly showcases Tsurumaki's own interests. I hope that in the future I can exercise my freedom as a creative to make something that sticks with people. that gives a voice to those weirdos out there. Interest just as niche as my own. PUBG is fully cool as an example of what great artists can make.